Hi friends, again I am back with another sewing project. This time you can see these are two old salwars. This is one salwar and this is another. Both of them are in the style of patiala, so you can imagine that it has a lot of fabric in it. Now I don't wear them any longer, so what I have thought is I'm going to upcycle them into a summer jacket. I won't be requiring a lot of fabric, so whatever fabric is left, then I'm going to think of some other project with those fabric left. But for the time being, before I give my idea a concrete shape, I need to rip off all the seams of this fabric. So again, for that I require a seam ripper. So this is the seam ripper I have shown you in my previous projects also. Very, very important tool in case you are into upcycling and sewing projects. So I just keep it. Now with this I'm going to rip off all the seams, and for that I need to turn over my salwars to the wrong side and then rip off all the seams along the seam line. So I do that, iron the fabric properly, and then I get back to you with the idea. So now that I have ripped off all the seams of both the salwars and got all the individual pieces, as you can see, I have also properly ironed them, and now I am planning to make a double-sided summer jacket out of this. So one side of the summer jacket will be made out of these two combined, with some panel stitched together as a patchwork, and for the other side it is going to be plain and from this scrappy fabric, which is again from an old this time a kurta of mine, white kurta, chicken curry kurta. And from this, the chicken work that I have, which was on the border of this of the kurti, that will become the front of my jacket, and the remaining part will become the back side of my jacket, one of the sides. So since with these two I'm going to do patchwork for one of the sides, that will be a little difficult, and that I'm going to explaining you how I'm going to do the cutting will become a little difficult, so that I'm going to take next. Before that, I'm going to show you how I'm going to cut my jacket with the help of this plain fabric, because it will become easier for you to understand, because it won't even involve any kind of patchwork. So for that, first of all, now this will be, both these pieces as I told you will become the front of my jacket, so it will be obviously the jacket will be open from the front, so these will be the two sides of the front of the jacket, and from this will be the back. And now you can see that both the pieces, I couldn't get one. If I try to fold it, one of the pieces, and then use this crop top, which I always use as the reference for my cutting, then you can see that it is much shorter than the width that I require. So what I'm going to do, since it's a DIY, I am going to sew this together to this so that I get the required width of the fabric. So let me do that. It will be a simple stitch along this side, a simple stitch. I don't have to bother much about the fraying part because it's a double sided jacket, so all the fray edges will get hidden inside the two layers of the jacket. So just one straight stitch on top of this. Both the pieces have been sewn together, as you can see, and I'll turn it to the wrong side and give it a fold, and on top of this I'm going to lay my crop top. So to measure the length of this crop top, I actually need to place the end of the tape at the highest point on the shoulder, which is towards the inner side, towards the neck. So from here, including this, including the seam allowance, it is 23 plus another half inch, so it is 24. Now I want my crop top to have a total length of 19, so including the seam allowance it is going to be 20. So this would be the length of my crop top. So accordingly I am going to adjust the crop top on top of this, because I don't have too much of length to this piece of fabric, scrappy fabric that I have. So I have to adjust very carefully and miserly and economically, you can say. So I place it in a way that from the bottom to the top of my crop top, it should measure 20 inches. It is exactly 20, as you can see. So accordingly I have adjusted the crop top on top of my fabric piece, and now I'm going to give it a cut, half an inch as seam allowance, and I cut it. Also from this side. Now I don't want to have an arch like this for the jacket. I want it to be straight. So I give a straight cut here. Here I don't have to bother about the seam allowance, because already I have the free edges with the seam allowance in the fabric. All of this I had already explained in the previous crop top which I made. You can see it. My previous video, if you go to my channel. And now here, now in this case this is a sleeveless crop top. Now sleeveless crop top where the sleeves are a little towards the wider side, it's not a deep cut. Now the jacket I want it to be deeper into the fabric, because I want the inner kurta or the dress that I'm wearing to show. This shouldn't hide, the bodice of my jacket should not hide, as you must have seen, it should not hide too much of the inner dress that I'm wearing. So accordingly I don't want to have the seam allowance included in my arms. I'll cut it just along it, so that when I sew it, it is going to take half an inch seam allowance from within the cut, and so it will become a little deeper. It will come half inch deeper inside the body. So I hope you understood that. So I'm going to cut it just along the borderline of my armhole of the, but be very careful that you don't cut into your reference dress. In this case it's a crop top. So here it is. So this is my back of the one side of my jacket. So I keep my crop top aside, and now taking this as the reference, I'm going to cut the front of my jacket. So the right sides are both inside. There's a very thin line of difference, you have to see it for yourself. And so the right sides are inside, and right sides have to be towards the inner side of the jacket. So I place it this way, and now as you can see, when I lay the front on top, there is a little gap towards the front of the jacket which is coming inside. That doesn't matter, because the jacket in the front will be a little less in its width. It has to be a little open from the front, you must have seen. It shows, it doesn't completely close on each other, the flaps of the front of the jacket. So I have almost around half an inch which is less, but that's fine. So, and I flip it to have the cut piece on top, and then as a reference I cut over the lines exactly the same way. So both the front and the back pieces are cut. Now let me give the shape to the front. Now for the front of the jacket, obviously I don't want the neck that deep. I want it to have a V shape. So just this way, and from the bottom I want to give it a round shape like this. So I give it a cut now. I'll also tell you so that you know how deep I have given the V shape. It's at 6 inches deep. So it's at 6 inch, and so it's a straight cut for the V shape. And from the bottom it will be a round cut. So this is how the front of the jacket will look. And one more thing that I have to do is I want the armhole to be cut a little deeper for the front, around. Half an inch deep. This is just by eyeballing an estimate. So this is done, and just the same way I also need to cut the other side of the jacket. Now for the other side of the jacket, I have already cut the back. Now this is the back with reference to this. I did the cutting. Both the back sides of the jacket are ready. For the front of the other side, I'm going to make some patchwork using these panels which I have cut already. So these are the panels. Now the only thing I have kept in mind while cutting these panels, this is again a scrappy fabric in green which I cut. The as I have done many projects earlier with the panels of fabric, rectangular panels, I always only kept in mind the length that I require for that particular project and not the width. So I had varied. Now because that again is a bit of stifling when you also have to bother about the accuracy in the width. So, and it also looks nice when you have different widths of the fabric being attached in sewing to a panel. So these are the various panels that I have. One is from the yellow salwar, one is from this shin sprint salwar, and the one is plain. Now the only thing which I have to keep in mind while cutting these panels was length. And the length, as we know, for our jacket is 20 inches. So just around 20 inches. So this is more than 20. So a little more than 20, I am going to give a straight cut here. Just to be on the safer side. Later on, when we cut it for the front, the excess fabric will get cut in any case. So I have these three panels now, and I have already sewn the panels together for one of the sides of the front. I'll show you. So this is how the panel turned out to be. With this as reference, I'm going to sew these panels together and show you. First is the green one to be attached to this printed fabric. Just keep in mind that you are taking the wrong sides of the two fabrics, right side of the two fabrics placed together to the inside, and then on the wrong side towards the fray edges you are going to give it a stitch with a seam allowance of 1/4 inch. Now this patched fabric is ready. I give it a press, nice press, and then I'll be ready for cutting it out for the front of my jacket. So let me iron it and then I get back to you. Now I'm ready with both the patchwork fabric ironed properly, and I'm going to cut the front of the jacket for the other side using this as my reference. Now for that I have to be very careful. So what I plan is, this will be towards the closed side of the front of my jacket and this will be towards the inner open side. So accordingly, very careful that I place the wrong side, right side of my fabric, and on top of that I place the right side of the other fabric, both of them facing each other, the corners and the fray edges matching each other for accuracy. Now I'm going to lay the previously cut fabric for the front of my jacket of the other side on top of these patchwork fabric so that they are accurately fitting each other. Now I want a little bit more of green to show, so I'll push it a little back like this, and now I'm going to cut it. Both the front and the back for the double-sided jacket, summer jacket, are ready to be sewn. So I'll once show you how this will look. So this is how the front will look for the other side of the jacket. I hope it will turn out well. And now let's get started with the sewing. Now before the sewing, let me also tell you what all other prep that I have done. So this will be all about the jacket, and just to finish it, I have also made these two doris with the green fabric. If you want to know how I made these doris, then do let me know in the comment section below, so that I'll have a separate video for making the dori. And the dori end decoration I'm going to do with some leftover fabric like this. So these fabrics will come to use then. And also this is a bias tape, a long one. This will be for binding the entire front and back of my jacket. Now how to make a bias tape, I have a detailed video on this previously made. If you want to check it out, how I make bias binding tape, you can watch that video. The link is in the description box below. Now for the sewing, I have already sewn one of the sides, that is the white plain fabric side of the jacket, together at the shoulders and towards the sides of the jacket and not the open side. So as you can see, is already sewn together, the two pieces. Just the same way I'm going to sew the other one and show you. So for that, I place back of the bodice of the jacket straight on this flat surface, and on top of that I match the two open fronts of the jacket with the right side facing down. Both the rights should be facing each other towards the inside, and this comes here just like this. And then I sew the shoulders and the sides with the seam allowance of 1/4 inch. Both the bodice pieces of the double-sided jacket are in place and they need to be attached together. Now before I attach both the pieces together, I also need to do a little prepping for the dori which I want to have in the front of the jacket. So for that, these are the two ready doris, and I need to decorate the open ends of these doris. For that, I have taken these scrappy pieces of fabric and placed them on top of each other. From the corner, straight edges I have taken. So these are the two longest pieces I have. So I have placed it like this, one on top of the other, and then give it a fold. And then, so I give it a rough circular cut like a cone, and taking this as a reference, these two pieces, which will be the shorter pieces, again I give it a fold and I cut it as a cone. Like this, and this, which is almost around somewhere in the center of both the widths, again I make a cone out of this. I give it a double fold for both the fabrics, and then matching up with this for the width, I cut it into another cone. So I have three layers of these cones made, and now I'll show you how I'm going to fix it to this. This is the one I already made, you can see up close. Isn't it looking nice from scrappy fabric? So I let the fray edges remain because it's a fine cotton and they won't fray any further. As you can see, even I'm trying to pull them. So just the same way, I'll give a demo from the other one. What I do is, I place the largest layer on top with the right side up, then the second smaller one with the right side up, and then the third one, the smallest, with the right side up, and then place this one end of my dori just at this point. And with the right side inside, I give it a fold like this, so that all the fray ends match each other. And now I'm going to give it a stitch from this end to this end twice. I'll just show you up close. As I turn it to the right side, all the layers of this fabric, so this is how the decoration looks like. So both my decorated final doris are ready. Now we have reached almost the final stages of getting the jacket together. So now what I'm going to do is, I have placed the right side of one of the sides of the jacket on top, and on top of that I'll place the right side facing down so that both the right sides match each other like this, and I'm going to close the armhole. So for that I need, now this time I have to pin it up because I want accurate placing of both the layers together. So I start pinning up the armhole side on the wrong side of both the fabrics, matching the shoulder joint first, and then matching the armhole bottom joint towards the sides of the I hope this is clear, and the rest of it I'll match it up together. And pin it. So they perfectly match up with each other. And now I'm going to sew it all along with a seam allowance of 1/4 inch. So I start from the shoulder joint and very slowly, there's no need to hurry, I start sewing. Now I turn it to the right side and show you. So I'll have to put this whole thing inside. So this is how the armhole looks like. As you can see, and I'm going to give it a good press and then get back to you. So this is how one side of my jacket looks like after I have turned it over to the right side and then given it a good press with all the seams hidden inside, as you can see on both sides, the back and the front. And now we'll also finish up the sewing of the arms to the other side. Now you have to be very careful how I pin it up. You watch me carefully. What I do is, now as it is placed this way with the right side showing up for the other side of the armhole which I stitched, I take it to this side and then turn it to the other side. And now as the two wrong sides are facing each other, from here I take the two armholes, and this is the sides of the bottom of the armhole where it attaches to the sides of my jacket. From here I am going to match the right sides together with a turn like this, and then I am going to pin it up. So as I did for the other side here, first I pin the armhole bottom, and now I go to the shoulder side of the arm and matching the seams of the shoulder joint, I pin it up. Just like this. And remaining portion I am going to do as I did in the other side. Just don't give any stress on any of the layers. Just very lightly match up the seams, match up the fray edges and pin it up. Just don't worry about all the puckering that is happening going on because of so many layers on the wrong side. We have two sides of it is a double sided jacket. So you just have to worry that these all match up, and the directions that I gave initially, you follow them while you are joining the two sides of the arm with the sewing. So now all around the armhole I have the proper matching of my pinning up. And now just following the pin, I am going to sew it. So we have reached the other end of the armhole again. And we will stitch over the previous stitch just to lock it. And now I just turn it over to the right side. And now in this case you don't even have, just turn it over to the right side. So this is how it looks now. So before I move further with my sewing, I need to give it a good press just like the other side, and then I get back to you. So we have reached till this stage, and now we need to fix these dories to the end and also lock the entire, sew the entire length of the border from the neck as well as the bottom of the jacket. Now this I'm going to do with a top stitch and a seam allowance of around 1/2 inch, because on top of that we are going to give a binding using this bias binding tape. So let us first do that. And for that, since we want accuracy and a neat finish, we are going to pin it up before we sew the two pieces, two sides of the jacket together. Now we'll give it a top stitch. With the seam allowance of 1/2 inch. So I have removed all the pins from the entire border, and now I am going to attach the bias binding tape all around. One side I will be doing it with a machine stitch, and the other side of the binding I will be doing it hand stitch. So let's get started. So I'll start from somewhere at the end, because in the front I want a very neat finish. So keeping that in mind, I'll start fixing it along the stitch line that I already have. This will be my reference, and on top of that I'm going to sew it together to the main body. So first I'll leave around 3 inches and then I'll start. So you have to match up the right side and the right side of the tape always. So on the wrong side we are sewing it. Closing up to the finish, the other side of the binding, I just give it a fold of around 1/4 inch, press it, and then on top of that I am going to sew this. So as I reach the end matching up, just the way I have left this excess of quarter an inch, I'm going to leave an excess on this side also and cut it off. So now I'll match up the ends with the bottom one, the other end of the tape which lies flat with a fold of quarter of an inch, and on top of that this layer, and then I sew it. So you can see that the bias binding tape has been attached to one side to the entire inner perimeter of the jacket, and also whatever towards the inside, if there were any fray edges which were uneven, I have also trimmed them so that all of them match up together, as you can see. And now we are going to complete the binding with the help of needle and thread, and so my needle and thread is also ready. And also I'm going to fix these two dories with needle and thread only. So I'll start from this end also. Along the curved edges, let us first give some notches towards the fray edges so that it doesn't penetrate into the seams. That's very important. It should, so only along the curved edges I keep these notches. On the other side of the open front, for all the layers, this will help you get rid of any puckers. So it's all done, the notches are done, and now we are going to sew it with needle and thread. So I'll get a little up close and show you how I do it. I start from this end, so I'm going to give it a fold of around quarter of an inch and then give it another fold. So this is how it sits. And then I start giving it a hem. So this has to continue for the entire perimeter towards the inside of my jacket. This is going to take a lot of time. I'll show you initially and then rest of it I'll do it and get back to you. Of course I'll show you one side of how I attach the dori also. Hand sewing has so much more control and neatness.
So you can see this is how it looks. I started from here and this much I have done. So this way I'll come till this end. So this way I'll do this entire length, and when I get to the point where I have to attach the dori, I'll get back to you. I have reached the point where I have to attach my first dori. So I'll show you how up close. So I take the raw end of my dori, put it inside the binding, maybe half an inch, and then along with the layer of this dori, I'm going to give some stitches here for all the layers caught inside, and give some more tucks here to lock it, and then give some back stitches again just to secure the dori. And now again, after giving the back stitch to the other end of the dori, again catching all the layers together, I give some stitches. So you can see that it is nicely firmly secured. And now I'm going to continue with the binding. So I continue with my binding just the way I was doing it earlier. And this way I'll do the entire length, and when I get back to the other end of for tying the other dori, I again give you another instruction. After hand sewing the entire perimeter of the inner side of my jacket, I have almost reached the end, but before that I have at present reached the point where I have to attach the other dori. So I'll show you. So around half an inch of the raw edge, I insert it inside, I push it inside so that they are both at the same height, and then continuing with my seams. So continuing with my seams, first to this side I catch the layer of this white fabric, the dori and the binding, and then I give a stitch here and then overlap with few more stitches so that this end of the dori gets locked, and then again I catch all the three layers and give a sew and reach the other end, and then again catching all the three layers, the binding, the dori and the white fabric, I give couple of locking stitches here. So you can see that this is completely locked, nowhere to go, and now I complete the remaining binding. So it's done. I'll just give a couple of knots here and finish with my sewing and snip off the thread. So this is how my jacket, double-sided summer jacket, looks like finally. So if you want, you can tie it. Do you like it? If you like it, then definitely I deserve a thumbs up and a sharing. And subscribe to my channel for many more such creative videos in which I sew from completely scrappy fabric or else an old dress. and this is the other side of the jacket. So the tip I would give is, if you're wearing a colorful dress, then you should go for the solid plain of white side of your jacket. And in case you are wearing a plain dress or a kurti or a salwar kurti, then you can, or a trouser for that matter, you can wear this printed side. So I hope you enjoyed this sewing tutorial, a DIY double-sided summer jacket. If you like my idea, then of course I deserve a thumbs up, and please subscribe to my channel and do not forget to hit the bell notification icon to be updated with all my upcoming videos, and share it with your friends and family. Also, you can follow me on Instagram, and till the next time that I come up with another creative sewing idea with completely scrappy fabric, keep watching my channel. Bye.